Hey Apex Agents, Mobius Y here with another video for Mass Effect Andromeda's multiplayer. Today's video is a weapon profile video, and we're covering another one of the game's shotguns, the Scattershot. Now, the Scattershot is a Remnant technology weapon, meaning that it does not run on conventional ammo. Instead, it operates by a cooldown mechanic where if you constantly shoot the gun as much as possible, it will eventually overheat and require a lengthy recharge time. However, if you shoot the gun without causing it to overheat, it will actually recharge its full magazine much more quickly. This dynamic on its own gives the Scattershot a lot of flexibility over the other shotguns in that it eliminates a player's reliance on visiting resupply crates, allowing them to continuously move around the map handing out damage or staying in the same spot and trying to hold a specific location. This gives players the freedom to never cease from killing enemies and depleting the wave budget or completing objectives. The second aspect of the Scattershot being a Remnant technology weapon is that it also gets a damage bonus against shields. While several shotguns have a damage bonus against armor, including the Scattershot, the Scattershot's bonus damage against shields is actually even higher, allowing you to strip shields on various sub-bosses or even boss-type units much more quickly than you might with other types of weapons. Another unique aspect of the Scattershot is that it fires its multiple pellets in a specific pattern every time. Almost every other shotgun, save for example the Crusader or the Dan, fire their pellets in randomized spread pattern over a specific radius, with the radius' size depending on accuracy. However, the Scattershot shoots its 5 pellets, where 4 of the pellets create the corners of a square, and the 5th pellet is right in the middle of them. This gives the Scattershot not only high accuracy, but allows players to reliably get as much damage as possible per shot by landing all pellets at the desired impact point on enemies. In short, it's much easier to keep hitting weak points. The Scattershot's flexibility unfortunately does not completely make up for a couple of its shortcomings. First off, it is not a hit-scan weapon, so the pellets are fired in a projectile fashion, meaning moving targets could very well quote-unquote dodge your shots if you are not leading them properly. Also, the Scattershot's damage values do lend it adequate burst and sustained DPS that is better than many other weapons in the game. However, it still is outclassed by some of the top-end shotguns like the Piranha or Shorty, and even a few pistols like the Roserad or Silhesh. Lastly, since the Scattershot is a rare-grade weapon, it could take quite a while for newer players to unlock the base weapon itself, let alone any of the special variants. Nevertheless, the Scattershot's adaptability and usefulness should not be overlooked, especially by newer players who are only recently beginning to unlock and upgrade their rare-quality characters and weapons. The Scattershot is a fantastic weapon for short-range bruisers who utilize their powers and even melee attacks in combination with their weapon. For example, the Human Vanguard or Asari Duelist could make great use of the Scattershot since it can be equipped with a melee-enhancing shotgun blade attachment and completely negates the need to ever visit an ammo box. If the option is available, I recommend using a Siphon variant to give your character the ability to self-heal while also dishing out damage. That's it for today's weapon profile. Let me know in the comments below how you feel about the Scattershot shotgun, what classes you like to use it on, and how you feel it compares to other shotguns or even other types of weapons in the game. This has been Mobius Y for Mass Effect Andromeda's multiplayer. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you on the battlefield. Good luck, Apex.